Hi, and welcome to session six of the Build Your Custom Website course. My name's Dan. I'm a software engineer and systems analyst with WP Update. In today's session, we're going to be covering cleanup and tweaking of your website, doing some quality assurance or QA, and doing the soft launch for your site. You will need fresh eyes. So I recommend doing this when you're bright, fresh, maybe first thing in the morning after a coffee or two. Do not do this when you're tired. Do not do this when you're in a rush. Very important. You'll also need a trusted friend or family member or associate that you can ask to review your site on your behalf. If you choose a workmate and you're doing this as a side hustle, I really recommend making sure they can be trusted not to tell anyone about it at this point. So quality assurance, or QA as we like to call it in the industry, is the process of reviewing a site to make sure it's fit for purpose. It has a couple of different components, and for our purpose, we're going to be reviewing the text, reviewing the setup, and also doing our own user acceptance testing, or UAT, which allows us to review the site with fresh eyes as a visitor would see it. This helps us pick up silly mistakes and also make sure that it makes sense as a package. So, a couple of quick tips for QAing. The first is take at least a day's break before you do this. So if you've done this session, this course end to end in a day, now is not the time to be QAing your work. Take at least a day's break from the last time you looked at it to make sure that you have fresh eyes. So be fresh and bright and not overtired. Do not do this at the end of the day. You want to do this when you are sharp. You also want to make sure that you have enough time to get through the whole thing. If you're rushed, you will miss things. If you can avoid interruptions, that's also very, very handy. If you are doing this while you've got the kids getting ready for school, or you're in a shop getting interrupted all the time, again, you'll miss mistakes. I also highly recommend using a grammar or spelling checker service. So, all right, and also another quick tip for checking grammar and spelling mistakes is read your pages from bottom to top, back to front. So by reading stuff in reverse, your brain doesn't fill in the gaps in a phrase or in a sentence. It forces you to look at the individual words to make sure they make sense. All right, so let's go. Let's start by jumping on our homepage. Okay, so once we've brought up our site, we will need to go into the URL again, and same as always, wp-login.php, and hit enter. Let me just zoom in again and pop in your username and your password. Okay, and that takes us out to the dashboard. Go up to the top of the page where you've got the site name, and then mouse over the little icon there and hit visit site. Okay, and then the QA process is just scrolling down to the bottom. And okay, so we need to update that. So let's edit with Elementor. So I've just center clicked that with my mouse, or you can also right click and open link in new tab. So we'll click on that one. Scroll all the way to the bottom. Whoops. It's a bit jittery. There we go. And we can start picking up this as a mistake. Fantastic. All right, so that one's fixed up. Notice the contact form there as well, which we will need to deal with quite separately. That's the first mistake fixed. Publish that, or update that. Excellent. Okay, and then go back to the original tab, refresh the page. Okay, and there we can see the address. All right, so reading back to front. And then as you go up, just read through everything. Now, I also noticed, I think, for these buttons go nowhere at the moment, so we'll quickly fix those up. So back into the tab with the editing window, and then we want to click on the button. All right, so we now delete what's in the link there, click the, let's see if it will just pick up the about page. There we are. So by typing in the link name, it will find pages in your site that it can link to. So we want to click on that one. And there's another button here. Actually, I'm going to make this our partners page. Delete that and then type in partners. There we go. So that's those buttons connected up. Update again. Okay, and refresh the page. All right, so we can see now the buttons are all connected up just by mousing over them. And we can confirm that they in fact go to the right place by clicking on them. And that's taken us to the partners page there. And the no more page has taken us to the about there. All right. So what I'd like you to do now is pause this video and go through every single page on your site. Don't worry so much about the terms and conditions and the legal pages we made in the last session, because they've already been essentially QA'd by Termly there. But for every page that you've made, go through the site and then come back to me in a few moments. Fantastic. All right, I'll assume that you've completed QA, you've been through absolutely everything, and you now have square eyes. So if you've not taken a proper break, go and take a break for 5 minutes, come back with a cup of tea or a cup of coffee. Once you're done, then we will head into the dashboard and we'll start on the tidy up side of things. So dashboard. And the first thing we're going to do is go through the appearance and the customized settings. So appearance, customize, and then once that loads up, we're going to go through each one of these options and look for anything that's a little out of place. So for WordPress default, site identity, I've got all of our logos in there, so that's correct. Go back, homepage settings, that's all correct. And then additional CSS, if you joined us for the other video, you'll have some stuff in here. If not, fantastic. All right, and then back again and on to the next one. So we're just going through here looking for anything that looks a little bit out of the ordinary. So the headers are all fine there. Sidebar, we're not worrying about for this exercise. Blog, also not worrying about for this exercise, but you can come back to the masterclass for that one. Now the footer. All right, so in the footer at the moment, we have the quick links, we've got the legal and these two other blocks, as well as the Zeta theme information. We want to get rid of that Zeta theme info. And what we're going to put there instead is I'm going to swap that out for the legal menu. So in the below footer, that's presently got the center one set. I'm going to change that over to 2. In the first column, I'm going to have text, and we'll put our little copyright notice. So C 418 and name of my company. And then on the right, the second column, I'm going to put in a menu. Excellent. And we'll go to the menu there. So that'll take us out and pop that in. Footer below menu. And we want the legal in that one. Great. So what that's done is that's given us the 2 columns there. And that means we can delete this legal one a bit later on. So we'll publish that. We'll save that. Now, this is a little bit confusing. It's actually jumped us completely into another section. So we'll go back again. And I believe we were in layout. So that's the footer. Scroll to top. I think we need to change the color for that one. So let me grab the color picker. We'll just pick that. And there's a link in the description below to how to get one of these little color picker extensions, which are really, really handy. All right. Just paste that in. And then paste that in. Excellent. And that means our little scroll to top is now on brand. Okay. Back out. And that's the layout taken care of. So next one is color and background. So global colors, we've already set these previously, so that's all good. And the hamburger color, I think that's a bit dark, so we'll click that and we'll paste in the brand color. Publish. And then back. And now that's done. And basically, we're just going to go through absolutely all of these to make sure that the colors are correct, to make sure that there's no errant logos or anything else in the site that shouldn't be there. So we'll skip forward to once that's been completed. Okay, so that is absolutely everything gone through, including updating some of the colors, some of the fonts, and then changing things like the name of the coffee gallery there. One more thing while I'm there, I'm just going to get rid of this second menu item in the quick links menu now that we have the privacy and cookie policies over on the right. So let's go into the footer widget area and just select that little drop down and hit remove and publish. So now we just have quick links there, and you can add just about anything you like there, but quick links works for us. All right, so we'll close out of that one. The next thing we need to do is the contact form. So let's scroll on off to the left there, and you'll see contact form and contact forms. And this is only if you have one on the front page or on one of the other local pages. So we'll just dismiss that. It'll have contact form one. Click on that. And then all we need to do is go into mail and set the emails to your to and from. So it'll be hello at your email. And then the from, I like to set that as the from name for the user. So that will be from, and then we're looking for your email. And what that means is that when you receive a message from the contact form, you can simply hit reply, and the email client will just pick it up and send it straight to the customer. Oops, I'll set the subject to great. Okay, and then that is all set from there. We can delete that as well, we don't need that. One more thing to do is go to additional settings and then delete anything that's in additional settings here. Otherwise, it won't send. All right, hit save. Don't worry about the little exclamation mark there. That's perfectly fine. That's normal for this one. There's some extra validation there, which we're not interested in. And now the contact form will be pointing to you. So one of the other things we'll need to test then is by visiting the site. So I'm center clicking here, so it'll come up in a new tab. But you can also right click and then open in new tab, grab that, and then send yourself an email here to make sure it gets there. All right, and hit submit. There we go, and that has been fired off. So that's it for the core QA. Okay, so back into the dashboard, and we did overlook this one a little bit earlier. Scroll down to settings, and then into reading. Great. Okay. And then we want to scroll down and uncheck the discourage search engines from indexing this site. And that's it. Site is now live. The last thing to do in this session is to dive back into the site ground control panel. And we're going to set up some updates, some routines, and we're going to learn how to check our email. So head back over to siteground.com. And then mouse over or click on the login and then enter the email address you use to sign up in the very, very first session. And of course, your password. Go to websites. And then to site tools for the web for the website that we've set up. Great. Okay, so email accounts. Then under actions, we can log into webmail. And if you get a little doodad like that one, which is a pop-up prevention, just click options and allow pop-ups from tools.site. All right, so we have our email accounts there. Then underneath actions, click on the little ellipsis and then log in to webmail. Okay, so this is our email, and you can see there in our inbox is the test form that we sent before. So now we can click on that one, and that would send an email off to the person who made the inquiry. In that case, that's us. Okay, so that's how we check our email. There is also an option here if you're feeling a little bit inclined to configure your mail so that you can set up Gmail, you can set up Hotmail, or your own email client to pick up the email and send emails on your behalf. Tons and tons of resources on Google on how to do this, but I'll link a few in the description below. So cancel that for now. All right, so just to remind you again, that is into that's site tools, my site ground. Okay. All right, so to reiterate, that's websites, site tools, email accounts here, then ellipsis, and log into webmail, and then that's your email. So the next thing we're going to do is make sure our WordPress installation stays up to date. We want to keep it up to date because that helps keep it secure and safe. So to the left-hand side, click on WordPress, then auto update. We want to set up that one so that it's got our domain there. That's set as up to date. And then auto update settings are major release is 24 hours, minor release, I like to leave that 24 hours. And then make sure that update plugins is set to on. And then that's it. That'll keep our WordPress site up to date. Now, because this is using the WordPress auto update and that is managed by SiteGround, we don't need to worry about any updates within WordPress itself. It just gets dealt with. So if you see updates plastered all over the WordPress dashboard, just ignore them. That's fine. All right, so monster session this time around. We managed to clean up any outstanding bits and pieces on the website. We connected up the contact form to make sure that that was all working and tested that. Connected buttons to other internal pages, again, if you had them. Learned how to access the webmail, and there are some links again down the bottom on how to set that up with your local email, as in your Outlook or Mac mail, and or how to set that up with Gmail or Hotmail as well. We made sure updates were switched on search engine indexing, and performed a soft launch with a couple of trusted colleagues, friends or family members. So absolutely monster session this time around. We achieved a lot. In our next session, which is the first bonus session, we'll be looking at a couple of ideas for your hard launch, things that you can potentially do for promotion, and how to make sure your website gets out there. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you in the next session.